Lord of the Rings Online, the Shadows of Angmar. An MMORPG developed by Turbine, which will be coming out soon, or probably already out if you're watching this past the time that it re is released. Well, here's some of the, these are the races for the humans and the dwarves and hobbits and elves. These are the people who fight Mordor. Mordor is probably going to be available after the beta test is done. It wasn't available in the beta, or else that's probably who I would have picked. I played a little bit of the dwarves and most of the humans. As you can see here, the graphics are freaking awesome. Some of the best you can see in an MMORPG. But you need to have a pretty good graphics card. Mine meets all the recommended requirements, but I have it turned all the way up here. And, well, as you can see in some of the later clips, I get some pretty bad frame rates. This is just me turning everything up, and you can sort of watch as the frame rate goes down and down, but the graphics go up and up. For the most part, it runs pretty good, as long as you don't have everything turned all the way up, unless you have like a really good system. I probably shouldn't have made these clips as long, because I... Oh well. Well, anyway, my processor and my graphics card are really pissed off at me right now. Well, here you can see most of the game world. The user interface is gonna look pretty familiar, since it's basically taken from a different popular MMORPG. I'll just let you go ahead and guess on which one that is. The dude's face looks pretty good for an MMORPG. He kind of looks like a laid-off Trailer Park Robin Hood, but that's okay. Here we are walking down the road, going somewhere to do something. I can't remember what I was doing, but here it is. The graphics are really good. As you can see, getting resources and stuff is pretty much the same as any other game. You can see it up in the corner. That's that little blue dot in the mini-map. I don't know if you can see it. You just go and pick it up. One of the cool things is if you click on it, the text will show up in the map in the game world right over it, so it's not so impossible to find. This is a clip of fighting a bear with the insane graphics on. As you can see, the frame rate's pretty bad. Oh, this guy's a hunter, and though you can't get pets, you do enough DPS to where you don't even need one. Here's I think it's called Combe or something. Pretty neat little town. Looks pretty good if you're standing still and you're not using fraps trying to get as much of it as you can. Yeah, the frame rate goes all to hell right here because there's a bunch of other players running around. That's the bar. You can go in there to train up your skills once you level up. About the same as, you know, on other MMORPGs. And this is, I just decided I was just going to stand around since the frame rate was so bad. Some guy was standing there smoking. Yeah, there's a smoke emote in this one. All the potheads are going to love that one. As you can see, the detail is really, really insanely good. You're going to want a really good graphics card and a pretty good processor too, because it was kicking my computer's ass. Well, I decided to dance around, see if anybody would join me, which nobody did. Feel all lonely now. Kind of taste me. Gonna move on to the community is not very talkative and doesn't seem to want to help you, although they probably don't know what the hell's going on either. I didn't manage to find a group for anything. I managed to join a guild though, which was kind of weird. Well, this is the storyline quest. Well, your first mission for a dwarf. You can see some characters from the movies and the books, like there's Gandalf. He's just sitting there, chilling, talking to some random dude. You can sit there and listen to it if you want to, or you can just go. A little burning ring above somebody that pretty much means that they got a quest. So you click on them, and then they'll tell you, well, come over here and do this. Though he decided he was gonna walk as slow as he possibly could. And then he didn't go all the way there. He's like, whoa, it's over there around the corner, you fucker. So, after you decide you want to go over there, you just walk over there. Oh, and the people that you need to see, to talk to, most of the time will show up on the mini-map, which is awesome that they did that. And I like how they labeled the door, because, you know, sometimes it's hard to figure out if it's a door or not. Oh yeah, there's a lot of loading screens in this game, by the way. And there's Gimli, everyone's favorite dwarf.
Have you come to help?
Yeah, I guess I have come to help. Well, then he walks over here, tells you, go talk to the dwarves, because Gandalf's about to leave, and do some ceremony or some bullshit. Hey, that guy's talking about a troll. And hey, I just talked about, I don't know. And then Gimli disappears. Well, here we see Gimli telling this guy, don't mind there, you dumbass, that wall's gonna fall down. And of course he doesn't do it. He doesn't stop. What the fuck with it? He don't give a shit. Then the wall falls on his dumbass head. I'm gonna apologize because I kind of forgot which button was to bind the movies, and that little thing right there was supposed to happen. Oh look, it's that troll that guy was talking about. Yeah, he knows that the guy just kind of fell down and died. I forgot which button was to bind the get the clips, so I kind of screwed up there. Oh well. We see all the good stuff anyway. There's Jason Gimli. Shit's falling down. This guy's like, oh my god, we gotta go and help him because he's not gonna help him by himself. That was a little loud, but okay. This is just my dwarf here fighting some of those things. I don't know what the hell they're supposed to be, but he's fighting them. Yeah, I'm not sure how this is helping Gimli at all, but okay. He sure is excited. Look at him go. Kick their ass. Kick him right square in the face. Yeah, this is the last one. I think. Beautiful. Alright, here's that scene. Once you finally get done with all that, you come up. I guess the idea of this game is you're that guy who's always just right around the corner of everything that's happening in the books and in the movies that happen in the storyline. Like, you're always just barely out of the scene. Like, yeah, he pounds the ground and he gets stunned, so you're, like, right behind this rock. And then Gandalf comes out and is like, what the hell are you doing? And the troll's like, bitch, I fuck you up. And he does some, like, things, and no, when he turns into a rock. Right as you wake up. And then they go and they start talking. Like I said, you're... that tries to follow the storyline and puts you into it. Like the humans, you get to see one of the ring rays, and he like comes up and talks some shit to you, but you're behind a fence, so you can't really do anything. And you can go up there and you can like stand there while they're talking, or you can just try to get the hell out. Oh yeah, this is where I kind of compare this to another game. Here you're fighting boars to level up, and here in this other MMORPG you fight boars and you level up. Here in Lord of the Rings Online, you can loot and get herbs and, you know, do all that fun stuff. And, well, look at the animation. Looks kind of familiar. I mean, MMORPGs, they borrow from each other a lot. But as you can tell from the user interface here, the chat, this the whole entire setup, this is basically just a mod of World of Warcraft. It's still a pretty good game. If you like to RP, you're a hardcore RPer, then you'll probably like it. Otherwise, you know, just stick with whatever else you're playing. That's my review. Sorry, I sound like some kind of retard. Oh, and this following scene's just ignore it.